Hello, 8th graders. We are going to start a new activity, which is Activity 5, Characteristics of Specific Immune Response. The specific immune response provides an efficient or hard defense against each microbe or each pathogen that infects our body, that attacks our body, and also provides a state of resistance of the subsequent infections by the same microbe, subsequent another infections by the same microbe or the same pathogen. Development of specific immune response. A child is more prone or more affected than adult to some diseases like rubella, haspe, chickenpox, jidrat almay, measles, الحصب الألماني, and mumps, أبو كعب, when the salivary glands in the mouth swollen or inflated. When a child is infected with any of the above diseases, he is not prepared and he defends himself first by non-specific immune response. When the viruses of the above diseases enters our body or the child's body, first the macrophages start attacking them. At the same time, he develops the cell-mediated and humoral-specific immune response that identifies the virus antigens, attack it more efficiently, and prevents reinfection. After that, the B and T lymphocytes help the macrophages to fight against these viruses and prevent reinfection. Immunological specificity. The cells involved in specific immune response are B lymphocytes that secretes antibodies and T lymphocytes that are killer cells. Each B lymphocytes produce a specific antibody, one kind of antibody that binds to a specific antigen to bind that bind to a special antigen. This means that there is a huge number of different huge number of kinds of B lymphocytes in our body. Each T lymphocyte has specific membrane receptors. These are the membrane receptors of the T lymphocytes that binds to specific antigens that bind each membrane receptor can each kind of membrane receptor can bind to only one kind of antigens. This means that there is a huge number of T lymphocytes in our body. Amplification. When a microbe invades our body, it selects B and T lymphocytes that recognize its antigen. These multiply and differentiate. B cells become able to secrete high amounts of soluble antibodies into the plasma, and T cells become killer cells. Here, the B lymphocyte attack the antigen. It multiplies, it increases in number. After that, it differentiates. It is able to secrete a huge amount of antibodies, and also it keeps some cells in its memory for the second attack of the same type of antigen. So, in the second infection, by this antigen, the memory cells, the B lymphocytes memory cells, attack them directly. Here, the T lymphocytes. The T lymphocytes recognize the antigen, it multiplies, then it differentiates. This means that it becomes a killer T lymphocyte, a killer cells, and some T lymphocytes are stored as a memory to T lymphocytes for another infection. Immunological memory. Let's discuss together this line graph. First, the title of this graph is the amount of antibody, the variation of the amount of antibody secreted as a function of days or time. Upon the first infection means the first entry of bacteria or viruses into our body. The B lymphocytes take approximately 13 days to start secreting a moderate amount of antibodies as a primary response. Primary response means the response against the primary infection, the first infection. The B lymphocyte secretes a moderate amount of antibodies and for a short period of time. When the body is infected another time, By a second infection, the second entry of bacteria or viruses into our body, the second entry of the same bacteria or viruses into our body, the B lymphocyte takes 5 days only to secrete antibodies, and it secretes a huge amount or big amount of antibodies during the secondary response. The secondary response is the specific immune response against the secondary infection, and this response take a longer time to end. This is a table of differences between primary immune response, the immune response against the first infection of a bacteria or virus, and secondary immune response, which is the immune response against the secondary infection by the same virus or the same bacterium. The latency period is the period needed by the B and T lymphocyte to start working by secreting antibodies or becomes killer cells. In the primary immune response, it is long. It takes a long time to secrete antibodies, for example, for B lymphocyte to secrete antibodies, whereas in the secondary immune response, it takes a short time because there is memory cells, B lymphocytes or T lymphocytes stored in the body. Because of that, upon the secondary infection of the virus or the bacteria, they directly fights against it. Amount of plasma antibodies, moderate. The antibodies secreted by the T lymphocytes upon the first infection is moderate, whereas in the second infection it is high. Duration of response in the first infection or the primary immune response is short, whereas in the secondary immune response, the duration of response is long. Thanks for your attention.